Hey everyone, my name is Brittany Timberlake. Welcome to this yin yoga practice with a bolster. I'll be using a variety of props. I've got a blanket, two blocks, and a bolster. If you don't have all of these things at home, you can get creative. You could use some pillows or a rolled up blanket to create your bolster. Blocks could be substituted with sturdy books. And one thing I'd like to mention before we get started, we still want to feel the tension and compression in these shapes that we're moving through in this yin practice. So if you feel too propped up, then feel free to not use any props at all. Let's begin in a caterpillar. We'll fold up a blanket so we can place that underneath our hips. And you might like to place your bolster underneath your knees. So as you start to come forward, you can make this a little bit more about the sensation through the lower back and spine. Or if you want to feel more into the backs of the legs, you could take your bolster and place it right on top of the legs and then coming forward from there. After you've wiggled around for a little while and found that sweet spot where you can settle into your edge, feeling a softening through the legs, the torso, softening your gaze or allowing your eyes to close. A gentle awareness comes to your breath. Feeling the breath moving slow and steady in and out of your nose. Bring a little bit of weight into your hands as you gently roll up through your spine. Just allowing for a pause at the top. Feeling your shoulders move down and away from your ears. And we'll move our props to the side. Leaning back onto the hands, bending your knees, and just allowing your knees to fall side to side. And we'll come into another forward fold. And we'll come into Dragonfly. We'll take the legs out into a wide V shape. And you have a few options with your bolster. One, you could have it on a bit of an angle, so your forehead comes to rest on it. Hands down on the earth. You might place your bolster directly in front of you and come to lay all the way down. Or you could create a little bit of an incline with your blocks. So taking your time to find the appropriate setup for you, exploring. Allowing yourself to come forward. Allowing the feet, ankles, and legs to relax. slowly releasing from this shape. Allowing for stillness at the top. Tuning into how it feels to slow down. To let go of the doing and the striving. Just to allow yourself to be. Helping your knees to bend, leaning back onto the hands as the knees windshield wiper side to side. And then coming back to center, just taking a couple breaths where we lift the sternum up to the sky. Creating a little bit of a back bend. And then releasing. Let's come into a butterfly. It's our last forward fold before we come into a back bend. So you might like to have your blocks underneath your knees. And your bolster, again, could be at a bit of an incline for support under the forehead. Or you might place your bolster right on your ankles and your feet and come to drape the torso forward and down. Returning to your breath if you've lost that connection. Feeling your belly expand on the breath in and the belly slowly constrict on the breath out. releasing from this forward fold. Rolling out through your shoulders. Rolling out through your neck. We'll bring the knees together, crossing the ankles, wrapping your arms around your legs. Give yourself a squeeze. Then we'll make our way onto our bellies, coming into a Sphinx. And we'll place that bolster in front of us. So you could either bring your elbows onto the bolster, creating a little bit more height, so you'd be feeling more compression through the lower spine, more stretch or tension through the abdomen, front of the thighs. If this is too much, you could come a little bit lower by bringing your bolster underneath your armpits and just extending your arms out in front of you with the hands resting on the earth and then your head coming forward and landing on the bolster. Notice if you've started to clench through your glutes and legs. Allow the entire lower body to soften and relax. mindfully making your way down onto the earth, moving your bolster off to the side. Your arms could be along your sides, resting on one cheek, or your elbows winged out, resting your forehead on stacked hands. Coming out of the rebound by coming up onto all fours. Moving through a few cat-cow shapes slowly. Releasing any residual tension and through the spine. And then coming into a neutral table, we'll make our way into either a sleeping swan, where the right knee comes in towards the right wrist as we walk the left leg behind us. You could have a blanket or block underneath the right hip. And the torso comes down, possibly onto the support of a bolster. If this is too much for your right knee, you could come onto your back in a figure four. We've been here for quite a few minutes. So moving slowly to come out. Normal to feel a sense of fragility or vulnerability. And you might like to release by coming into a downward dog. Or you might just shift the weight of your hips to one side, extending the legs out in front of you and leaning back onto your hands. And then when you're ready, we'll move into either sleeping swan or figure four on the other side. Can you relax a little bit more down through that left hip and IT band? The breaths in, creating space. The breaths out, releasing stress. releasing from this side. So we'll come into another back bend. We'll bring our bolsters to the back of the mat. Option one is full saddle, where we come to either sit on our heels or the feet walk out a little bit wider and we come to sit all the way down on our bum. So depending on how much internal or external rotation you have in your legs, one will feel better than the other. And then allowing yourself to come back and resting on the bolster. If this is too much for your knees, then you could come into a supported fish with the legs out long, or butterfly legs with the soles of the feet together, knees falling out, and then coming back. Choose your own adventure. Taking notice of where your body is making contact with the bolster. And then allowing those areas to become a little bit softer and heavier. Letting go of all muscular effort. Knowing that the bolster will fully support you. coming out of the shape. We'll make our way onto our backs so we can move into a twist. Just make sure that you have your bolster over to your left side. Draw your knees in towards your chest. Give your legs a squeeze. We'll extend the left leg out long so it comes to rest on the earth. And we'll take our left hand to help draw the right knee over to the left as we come into a twist. And you might like to take that right knee and rest it on your bolster. Your right arm could be by your side or out into a T-shape. Allowing your head to fall in any comfortable direction. Unwinding from your twist. And as we prepare to twist to the other side, just reaching for your bolster so it now comes onto the right side. Extend the right leg long on the earth. And then just use that right hand to help draw the left knee over to the right. slowly coming out of the twist. Draw your knees back in towards your chest, rocking side to side. And then reaching for your calves, ankles, or feet, coming into a happy baby. And then we'll make our way either into corpse, where we come to lay out flat on the earth. You may like to have your bolster underneath your knees. Or you could join me in a comfortable seated position, sitting up on your bolster. And as we come to close our practice, I'll just share a short poem called Just For Now by Danna Faulds. Just for now, without asking how, let yourself sink into stillness. Just for now, lay down the weight you so patiently bear upon your shoulders. Feel the earth receive you and the infinite expanse of the sky grow even wider as your awareness reaches up to meet it. Just for now, allow a wave of breath to enliven your experience. Breathe out whatever blocks you from the truth. Just for now, be boundless, free, with awakened energy tingling in your hands and feet. Drink in the possibility of being who and what you really are, so fully alive that the world looks different, newly born, and vibrant. Just for now. invite you to stay here in relaxation or meditation for as long as you have time for. Thank you so much for joining me on this rainy afternoon. I hope you can bring some of these chill yin vibes into the rest of your day or evening. Namaste.